We're still waiting breathlessly, of course, for the release of the Mueller report. For some, the final report is anticipated like the rapture, a religious event that will expose and destroy the incubus that is Donald Trump.
I personally think that what Mueller is heading to is not only the indictments, because remember, there may be more, right? He's not going to, you know, he's going to, there may be more coming down the pike,
right.
But also a report that discloses the extent to which Trump and his family are compromised by the Russians.
Compromised! How do I get to be a CNN analyst? Low bar, obviously. Others, though, are more cautious. They're warning that Mueller's report could be a disappointment in the end.
People who are closest to what Mueller has been doing, who have interacted with the special counsel, caution me that this report is almost certain to be anticlimactic.
Ken Starr is a former independent counsel, of course. He's the author of the book Contempt, a memoir of the Clinton investigation, and he joins us tonight. Mr. Starr, thank you very much for coming on, Judge.
Thank you,
so,
Tucker.
So I'm not sure which I'm rooting for, the anticlimactic version of the report or the report that actually answers the questions outstanding, but if it turns out the report does not find the president colluded with Russia and goes in another direction, shouldn't Mueller offer some kind of apology for gumming up the wheels of government for 2 years and destroying public confidence? I'm serious. And destroying public confidence
in every institution
this country has?
I understand, Tucker. I have a different view. And that view is that Mueller should bring this to a close. We've needed to know the answer about collusion for a long time, and I think he knows that answer. And I wish we would know that pretty darn soon, because that goes to the heart of American politics, et cetera, as well as our relationships with Russia. But here's why I'm not subscribing to the anti-Mueller view. All of the Republican leadership agrees, let him finish his work. Bill Barr, the nominee, and who's superbly qualified, is now saying, let him finish his work. And that's what I want him to do. Now,
right.
I will say,
well, let me just say, there's no group I respect less. So that holds no water with me. I'm just wondering, as an American, why wouldn't the interest of the country come before all of this stuff? Like, well, how are we benefiting from this protracted investigation?
Because Bob Mueller has been finding stuff that needed to be found out. Specifically, the 13 Russian individuals and the two organizations, you've read those indictments from some few months ago, and that tells a very powerful story about Russian interference, alleged, it's an indictment, but it doesn't, and this is, goes to the fundamental point, it doesn't have one word in those 35 pages in one indictment, many pages in the second indictment, that suggests collusion. So there's interference in the Trump administration, so leave Congress aside. The Trump administration agrees that there was interference, and there are sanctions against Russia and Russian individuals because of interference. Now, in terms of the report, I hope that the report will, in fact, be a report that is consistent with Department of Justice practice, which is you don't bring scurrilous charges. You don't make charges against people in reports. You either charge them, that is to say, you file an indictment, or you don't. And I think that's Bob Mueller's ultimate responsibility.
Right.
And that's the regulation. Listen, one of the many problems, as you know, with the independent counsel law under which I served is it called for this vast report to do what? To go to the House of Representatives for purposes of impeachment. Let's get the Justice Department out of that business entirely.
Yeah, I would say that the DOJ that read just leaking against people they don't like. A little scary.
Oh,
I would say.
That is terrible. In fact, let me comment on that, if I may,
very quickly, if you would. Yes.
When I read the New York Times article, my first reaction was, we need an investigation right now as to who leaked this. We think we know. What was their motivation and why the timing? This was many months ago, and there's been no suggestion whatsoever to support this outrageous charge against the president.
It's pretty scary. Ken Starr, thank you very much.
My pleasure, Tucker.
Tulsi Gabbard from Hawaii.